Welcome to Temple Otolaryngology. My name is Cecelia Schmalbach. I am a head and neck surgeon, the chair of the Department of Otolaryngology, and also the director of the Temple Head and Neck Institute. I often get asked why I chose to come to Temple, and that's an easy answer, because of the people. By people, I mean our talented residents that come through the program, our dedicated faculty, whom you will meet shortly. But by people, I also mean our neighbors of Northeast Philadelphia. At Temple, we truly do integrate with the community, and in doing so, have this unique opportunity to serve a patient population that's often forgotten. One of the many strengths of Temple Otolaryngology is that we are committed to quality, both in our participation in national clinical trials, the roles that we hold at various national, state, and institutional levels, but also in our membership of REGENT, which is the American Academy of Otolaryngology National Registry, dedicated to defining what quality otolaryngology care looks like for our patients. Another strength of the program is, because of the size, we are truly an otolaryngology family. And I think that affords us a unique opportunity to provide an ideal educational platform. There's a wonderful rapport between the faculty as well as the faculty and the residents. And let's be honest, at the end of the day, we spend a lot of time together. What we do as otolaryngologists is high stakes. And so it's important that we do it with people that we enjoy and that there's a team approach. It's my hope over the next 45 minutes that you can appreciate that Temple Otolaryngology covers the full spectrum of our field, both with respect to surgical subspecialty, patient population, disease entity, as well as a balance of exposure to both private practice as well as academics, and a host of different education and research platforms. I've shared a little bit about myself and what resonates in my heart: family, team, service, quality. But what's more important is what resonates in your heart so that you can find a program where you will truly excel and thrive. Come spend some time with us and see.
My name is Karl Whitley, and I'm Associate Professor of Otolaryngology, Head and Neck Surgery here at Temple University Hospital, and I am Program Director. I came to Philadelphia in 1990 to begin my residency, and basically never left Philadelphia. I'm so glad that you're taking some interest in our program. You're gonna meet some of our amazing faculty and our amazing residents and learn a lot about this program. Temple is located in North Philadelphia. We are a safety net hospital and vital to Philadelphia as a whole, and frankly, vital to the entire southeastern Pennsylvania region. We are a 732-bed hospital with 20 residency programs, 20 fellowships. Our rotations are here at Temple Main on Broad Street in North Philadelphia. We also have an affiliate hospital, Jeans Hospital, which is in the northeast section of the city, which is largely a community setting. On that same campus, we have Fox Chase Cancer Center, which is an NCI-designated cancer center. Fox Chase is involved in nearly 200 clinical trials. It has a special place in the history of oncology in America, and it is perhaps one of our residents' favorite places. St. Christopher's Hospital for Children has a very special place in the history of pediatrics in America. We have other rotations at the Abington Surgical Center, where our residents spend time with our plastic surgery colleagues. We also have a rotation in Pittsburgh at Allegheny General Hospital, which is where a significant portion of our residents' otology experience takes place. So I'm very proud, very happy that we have these unique and very busy affiliations for our residents to train in. We have somewhere between 24 and 25 faculty that you will interact with over the course of your 5 years in this residency program. All of them have amazing training, and you lead this program with a small piece of all of those individuals. In general, I feel that this program has all the pieces for a resident to be fully trained and ready to go to the next level. I'm so happy that you took interest in our program. I hope that you have a chance to come here and visit us. As they say around this part of Philadelphia, go Hawks.
So one of the things that I'm most proud of as Associate Program Director is the two-year curriculum that we've developed. So it is faculty-led and has lectures both by our faculty as well as by outside speakers. We also have visiting professors. It covers almost every aspect of the field, but also has some unique features. So we have a business and medicine curriculum, we have a research curriculum, and a leadership and team building block that we do as well. We have mock oral boards that take place at the end of every block, and our residents also participate in a variety of different simulation courses, some of them that we have here at Temple, others that they travel and go nationally for. So we have an airway simulation course that we do, a soft tissue skills course that Dr. Serena runs, a maxillofacial plating course, and a whole day cadaver dissection.
Hi, my name is Dr. Jeffrey Liu, and besides being a head and neck cancer surgeon, I'm also the director of research here for the department. In our department, all residents are expected to perform scholarly activity during their residency. We encourage research in a culture of academic thoughtfulness and investigation. Successful acceptance of a presentation almost always gets a resident to the meeting. And as you can see, we've had a lot of success with our department. In the last year, we've had 34 peer-reviewed publications, 82 oral and poster presentations, and 22 book chapters. So in the last few years, for our two major meetings, both at COSM and the American Head Neck, the American Academy of Otolaryngology meeting, somewhere between about a quarter to a half of our residents are able to attend that meeting, all because of their successful research, either with a poster or a presentation. So for our department, there's a culture of scholarly productivity and research, which we teach our residents, and we show them how to perform successful scientific evaluation, and we support a culture of inquiry. And as you can see, the hard work of our residents and faculty really shows in all the successes over our years.
My name is Adam Symanowski. I am the laryngeal surgeon here at Temple and also the clerkship director. I'd like to let you know a little bit about how things work with the residents here in clinic. We do quite a few procedures, not just flexible laryngoscopy. We do in-office injections and laser procedures. We also have clinics that represent all the subspecialties of ENT, so you're really getting involved in both the OR and the office procedure side of things. There's quite a bit of autonomy here, especially as you move through the years of residency. I think our residents do a really fantastic job of taking care of patients and really owning their care. So these are all things that we think are important and we hope you think are important too.
First year is split up into 6 months on service and 6 months off. The 6 months off service are 1 month each of anesthesia, OMFS, neurosurgery, surgical ICU, radiology, and radiation oncology.
And in terms of your 6 months on service, it's actually split up into 2 3-month blocks, an inpatient block and an outpatient block. So these are predominantly regarding head and neck and laryngology. As interns ourselves, we actually get to be in the OR at least once a week. We spend one day on Tuesdays with Dr. Isaacson, a pediatric otolaryngologist, in which we get to do our own TT placements as well as adenoids and things like that. Hold on tight, we've got so much more to sell you.
Yeah.
Hi, I'm Sydney. I'm Nikki, and we're part of the Temple team.
Temple is where we have our biggest resident team. We're actually divided into two services, the inpatient and outpatient services.
The outpatient service, which I'm on now, is great. You operate a lot, you see a lot of great stuff in clinic. You do laryngology, plastics, you do a lot of general ENT, like septoplasties with Dr. Whitley, and then our head and neck team.
And head and neck, obviously, does a lot of head and neck, including flaps here at Temple with Dr. Schmalbach and Dr. Vendra. We really get the breadth of everything here at Temple, and our patient population is what we love most about it.
And we love being all together as one big team, so it's a lot of fun.
Hi, I'm Jess. I'm one of the Temple Chiefs. And one of my favorite things about my residency here is my junior residents. We get along really well. I think it definitely makes residency much more manageable. I will definitely be keeping in contact with my faculty here because they're all very approachable, and I have all their numbers on speed dial for next year when I graduate. Work is never over.
I'm Brian, the other second year resident. Let me take you down to Jean's Hospital.
Jean's Hospital is a community hospital in northern Philadelphia where we spend 6 months of our second year. As the only ENT resident here, we get a little more autonomy, but still get to work with the same attendings.
What type of cases do you do at Jean's Hospital? We do some laryngology, some otology, and some rhinology. Some might even call that ear, nose, and throat. Thanks for joining me here at Jean's Hospital. Let's send it over to Ben and Punam at Fox Chase.
Hey guys, my name's Punam. I'm one of the chiefs this year.
Hi, I'm Ben. I'm one of the fourth year residents.
And we're at our Fox Chase rotation doing head and neck cancer here. So as a chief, you do 6 months at Fox Chase and you do 6 months at Temple. So at Fox Chase, we split our time between the OR and the clinic, operating 4 days a week, taking care of cutaneous and mucosal carcinomas, as well as endocrine and salivary pathology. Being in both clinic and the OR allows us to not only hone in on our surgical skills, but allows us to really see our patients through their entire journey here.
I'm just starting my fourth year here at Temple, and I'm at Fox Chase right now with Punam. And as a fourth year resident, we begin the transition from junior resident to future attending. We gain a lot more responsibility in managing the different services, both during our time here at Fox Chase and while at Temple Main Hospital. We also get to spend time at Abington Surgical Center working exclusively on plastic surgery. We also have a great rotation in Pittsburgh with the Pittsburgh Ear Associates, where as the only resident, we have a great opportunity to work on the entire range of otology, neurotology, and lateral skull-based tumors.
And now for what everyone was waiting for, the call schedule!
So for juniors, it's really great. As an intern, you actually don't take any call alone. You're only on buddy call, and it's only 1 day of the weekend per month, so it's great. As a 2 and a 3, you do take primary call. This is about every 4 days or so, and then you do weekends, either on Saturday or Friday, Sunday. We cover Temple Hospital here. We cover our Pete's Hospital, St. Chris, every 3 weeks, and then we do facial trauma here at Temple every 4 weeks.
And then there's senior call, which is your fourth and fifth year. It's honestly pretty amazing. How it works is you have the junior go and see the consult, then they call the senior to run to tie them, and everyone comes up with a plan together before you call the attending. It's pretty minimal schedule, about 1 weekend, if that, a month, and then a few days during the week. And it's really nice to work on your teaching skills, kind of walking the junior through things, how to see consults and how to do procedures.
Well, pick me up with golden hand. Oh, me say, oh, me tell you to run.
All the way, all the way.
Nobody say, nobody on. Well, I would like to hold my little hand. How we will run, well, how we will cry. Send me on my way. Send me on my way.
We are
Temple Otolaryngology.